This is a quick video to show you how to search ResearchGate. It's a little bit tricky and there's some tips that I'd like to offer. So the first thing is when you sign on, you have to click on your face. It could be blank at that point. I would put some sort of icon in there. And so I'm going to click on my face and it will show me a line of things here. And the one thing that I'm interested in, and I'm setting myself up so ResearchGate understands what I'm interested in. So I click on info and I'm going to identify my skills and experience, and I am also going to identify the topics that I'm interested in. And as I understand it, then ResearchGate will present those topics to you occasionally in terms of articles that you might be interested in. It also, once you follow articles, it will push those articles out if the authors publish something new. So that's good. You get things right off the hot off the press. So once you have clearly identified your info, and I would fill in as much as possible because I like to establish my digital identity, you can go to the search box. And you would think that you could just search some keywords and the articles would come up. And wouldn't that be lovely? But that isn't the way that ResearchGate is organized. You can search, and I'm just going to click on that down arrow. You can search by researchers. So that means if you've already found an article, and as you develop articles that maybe, or find articles in an area that you're interested in, you can look at the authors. Chances are they will be on ResearchGate. And you'll type in their names. They may have more articles that they've written, which is kind of interesting, so that you can look at all those articles. You can often download them or make a request for the articles. You can follow the researchers. And so that, as I said before, would bring up articles, new articles that they've published. And you can look at people that they have published with, and that also might lead you to further researchers. So that's one way of looking at it. You take digital articles that you find perhaps in a library database, you look at the author and you search them up here. You also can search publications. So for example here, and so you always have to select this, and the default is researchers. So if funny things come up, it means you haven't selected publications. And when it says publications, it's really looking at the title, I believe. So I'm going to type in social media and learning, something I'm interested in. I could press enter, or I could click this search thing. I'm going to press enter here. And so the first article, internet. Cognitive failure relevant to self-efficacy, learning interest and satisfaction with social media. So I could download the article, but I'm interested in finding followers here at this point. So I'm going to click on this person. And they have a pretty high RG score. They have 74 publications. And they have interests that I'm interested in. So I'm going to follow this person. And I'm just going to bring this over so you'll see that it's blue follow. I'm just going to click on that. And now I'm following them, and I could send them a message if I wanted to about their article or if I had a question. So I can scroll down further and, oh, I don't know, what am I interested in here? I'm aware here too, I'm looking for articles, so let me just, I'm going to click on this person. Now they don't have a picture, and they're not actually on ResearchGate. You want to be aware of that. It says like, do you know this person? And they'll contact them. So they've chosen not to be on ResearchGate, but their article is. So here's another article I might be interested in. I can download the article, and I can also follow or take a look at this person to see what they've done. They're looking at social media here. I see a number of things with social media. They have 18 publications and a pretty good RG score, so I'm going to follow them. I'm going to click on that there. The other thing I can do, though, is take a look at people that they're top co-authors, and you can see that there's a pretty high scores here in terms of RG, and so I could take a peek at these authors and see if they're people that I want to follow or produce articles that I want to follow. And the last thing I can do is actually post a question, and that might be about an area that I'm looking for information in or related to my topic, and you can post the question here and you can ask the basic question. So think of it as a sort of a leader to get people interested in what you're doing or what you want to find out about, and then you can actually provide a little explanation of what you want. So if you're looking for resources or contact or information, that could work too. So those are some ideas about how to use ResearchGate to find the information that you need.